Recent statement and decision made by Defense Secretary James Mattis have led some to suggest his working to undermine President Donald Trump's agenda. Eric Pahorn, a spokesman for the Department of Defense, told Newsweek the notion Mattis has gone rogue is absolutely untrue. Why do something Mattis is rebelling against Trump? Trending has Mattis gone rogue, the Defense Secretary has stood against Trump multiple times. His idea recently started gaining more traction after a video surfaced on Facebook last week that showed Mattis speaking with troops stationed abroad. Mattis is seen saying our country right now. You got problem we don't have in the military. You just hold the line until our country get back to understanding and respecting each other and showing it. He had the power of inspiration. We'll get the power of inspiration back. Martin never explicitly referenced Trump in his remark, but many interpreted what he said as a well indictment of the president, and the video went viral. Subsequently, it was reported on Tuesday Martin's process from transgender ban, which further fueled the idea of opposing the president agenda. Some went as far as to label him a hero after hearing the news. But Mattis is not actually helping the band, and many have misinterpreted this development. In reality, Mattis has simply ordered a review of the band in order to determine how best to implement it. In a statement the Department of Defense released about this on Tuesday night, Mattis explicitly stated the department will carry out the president policy direction under the band, which was instituted through a memo from Sion August 25 not via a tweet, a form of presidential communication that Mattis is reportedly appalled by. Openly trans people currently in the military will be allowed to serve for the time being, but that does mean the band has been frozen. As some reports suggested, Don't Miss TV and Music Industry Love of Savage 91 Notable List of Reboot, Revival and Reunion Flooding 2017 The band is set to go into full effect on March 23, 2018, at which point openly trans people in the military will apparently be removed from service. Trans people have been allowed to serve in the military openly since June 2016. And it estimated there are up to 1,600 transgender troops on active duty and more than 4,100 in the reserve, according to the Rand Corp. Depending on the finding of the assessment Mattis has ordered, there is a slight chance he could recommend to Trump not to move forward with the ban, but at the moment, to nothing to suggest Mattis will do this. Research already show transgender people do not affect military readiness and reliability, which Trump has cited as justification for the ban. In his initial tweet on this issue, thetetpiestidentiferedtoterndeprpopleasurpdy, which was commissioned by the Pentagon, conclude allowing trans people to serve openly would have little or no impact on unit quotient, operational effectiveness, or readiness, and would be especially costly in terms of healthcare expenditure. Accordingly, any new study that conclude otherwise is likely to be met with skepticism. Mattis has questioned the number in the Rand study. Another side has not necessarily opposed to transgender ban. On top of the viral video and the confusion over the transgender ban, remark Mattis made in response to a tweet Trump sent about North Korea on Wednesday have boosted the notion he's rebelling against Trump. Most popular Trump say his tax reform plan is good for the little guy. If not Trump tweet, the US has been talking to North Korea and paying them extortion money for 25 years. Talking is not the answer. President was seemingly suggesting diplomacy is not a sound option in terms of convincing North Korea to dismantle it. Nuclear program. When asked about the tweet at the Pentagon later in the day, Mattis contradict Trump. We're never out of diplomatic solution. The Defense Secretary stated, responding to Mattis comment on North Korea. Former Hillary Clinton advisor Peter Dao tweet Mattis is asserting increasing independence from Trump view. Not sure where this is headed. Similarly, Wadewet, a progressive non-profit focusing on veterans that make it opposition to Trump well known, tweet, while second time in 2 days transgender ban was first that Mattis has moved to separate from Trump. Both of these tweets highlight how convoluted the narrative on Mattis is at the moment. as well as the apparent desire among many on the left to see member of the Trump administration defy the president. Like his decision to review the transgender ban, it could be said Mattis remark on North Korea represent a moment in which the defense secretary stood directly against the president, but it had led the first time Trump and member of his cabinet have not been on the same page. With that said, it is still a public premature to say Mattis plan to consistently stand against Trump moving forward. The defense secretary has a strong personality, and it's certainly possible he does agree with the president on an array of issues. Beyond the comment on North Korea, there have been other times when Mattis exhibited polar opposite perspective to Trump on issues ranging from the use of torture to the Iran nuclear deal. Mattis has also characterized climate change as a national security threat, which stands in stark contrast to Trump's stand on the issue. But it must be said the idea Mattis has somehow gone rogue is largely unsubstantiated. More from Newsweek.